good young fighter. He's got a path to work on here. I just wonder if he is still considering a move up to lightweight. He's so good, so effective at this, lightweight. He's so effective at this bantamweight division.
Well, they're wasting any time. Here we go. Here's a guy, Yerzhan Mussafirov, who I'm very impressed with. But you tell you what, his first loss of the year, we did this fight, was against the Matadors. Young fighter, Eric Flores, up until that point, he'd been undefeated. But think about this. This will be his eighth fight in this series since mid-November when we started. Mussafirov's 25-year-old weight, number one in the world in the series of boxing, lightweight division.
And he is good. He is really good, and you know what? Chadi is going to find out about that early because Mussafirov does not waste any time. Chadi comes into this undaunted, a lot of confidence from him.
Well, he has, his debut was in the semifinals, and he lost to a fighter, Seaman Grivachev from the Baku Fire. But he's competed in the Olympic Games, so he's been an Olympian. He's from Algeria. It's the beauty of the World Series of Boxing. We get fighters from all corners of the earth. Here's an Algerian fighting for Paris.
And unafraid. You get fighters from all corners of the earth, and they're unafraid, too. They'll get in there and fight with anyone.
Roberto Savid will be your referee. And they're going to take a minute here to do some entertainment. Well, they get the gloves strapped on properly.
Okay,
here we go. Roberto Servite, okay, final instructions. We're in the lightweight division as we move up the ladder. Here in the World Series of Boxing Team Finals. Chadi coming in, like I said, with a lot of confidence. You gotta wonder what it did to Mussafirov to go to Los Angeles after being undefeated all season, and young Eric Flores beat him down there.
And he just outgunned him. Eric Flores is a lot like Mussafirov is, you know? Mussafirov has been here before. I mean, he's a fighter that keeps his hands up well around his face. In the Los Angeles fight that you referenced, whenever they were announcing the decision, Mussafirov was like, no way. No, he was shaking his head. No, he didn't believe the decision, so he thinks he won that fight. But, you know, I had six fights that way.
You never think you lose a decision.
Actually, five, I think it was. Yeah, five.
Five.
81-5 is my record.
Lightweight division. Yeah. I should mention once again that it is 3-3 in team competition. History in the making. The inaugural season of the World Series of Boxing. They came all the way to Guiyang, China, city of Guiyang, in southwest China, to have the conclusion. And the people here couldn't be nicer in their support.
Right.
Turning out to pack this building at the university, at the Guizhou University here.
There are many of the college students helping here tonight, helping with the organization of all this. He's done a terrific job.
Shadi's got Mussafirov on his bicycle. Good right hand right there. I'll tell you what. Chadi only had one fight previously in the World Series of Boxing, and he must have learned a lot because he looks good here in the first round. He
looks very good. He's getting down low, too. Never let your opponent get underneath you.
He's got Mussafirov going back. Yeah. Mussafirov's tasted something he didn't like there early. Those punches would score international competition, but not effective under this scoring system, what Mussafirov just did there. Round one scheduled for five lightweight division. Chadi keeps coming forward. The Algerian. Wow, he's got Mussafirov going backwards.
Inside 40 seconds of this round left. And it's Mussafirov who tries to put on the pressure, but he's running into a lot of stuff.
Yeah, he's covering up a lot because he's tasted some heavy punches.
Exactly. His style has changed since before the Eric Flores fight in Los Angeles. He learned a big lesson in that fight.
Let's talk about something else though, Sean. How about the fact that this is his eighth fight?
Yeah.
That's going to wear you down.
Sure.
I don't care what kind of shape you have. Your body's going to be worn down.
Worn down, but he also has a lot of experience. He brings that experience into this fight tonight. You know, he's got the experience that Chadi does not. Yerzhan Mussafirov, very strong fighter. He does a nice job of keeping your hands up around his face, see there? And he catches those punches on his gloves instead of on his face. And he does a nice job of rolling with the punches as well. Coming back with his own shots, he occasionally will get hit, leaving himself open. Combination from him, but he is a different fighter today.
Well, I'll tell you why he lost to Flores, because he was too defensive. He was, Flores was more of a boxer. And the first round went to Chadi. I like that. I like knowing what the scores are.
Yeah, he's cut. Is there a cut on him?
I didn't see
Did
one.
I see one?
I didn't see anybody working on one. Remember, his teammates are right over here behind him in the blue corner. If you hear the cheering, this is coach and the owner of the team are over here.
Chadi has a wide stance. Look how far his feet are, how far apart his feet are.
He's just a pure fighter. You can tell that. Well, they're going to take a little breather here. That's the first 3 second lull we've had all night.
First time.
Except for when the gloves were taped. Hey, that's the kind of action we get. Now, Mr. Fearham kind of stepping up right here a little bit. Now, watch him now. He's completely changed, Sean. Mussafirov got that left hand down low now instead of up around both gloves around his head.
A little more determined in this round. That first round, he kind of wanted to see what Chadi has.
Oh, this is on now.
Oh, responsive crowd is so great. When you're a boxer and you hear that crowd that responds to your punches, it's so cool. Oh, good left kick to the head from Chadi.
And once again, he's trying to clean up now. That was a big punch. And I've noticed the Chinese fans, they're so respectful and quiet. And then when something happens, they really react. The rest of the time, they're really polite.
Yeah.
It's not like a Vegas crowd where they're screaming the whole time. They're very polite. Mussafirov went to the body there effectively. He's walking right into some stuff. Mussafirov came out in the second round and said, it's on.
Well, it's different.
Oh, a nice sneaky left right there from Chadi. Boy, things turn around quickly in the World Series of Boxing from last night to tonight when these coaches. It's important to remember these coaches have a lot to do with the strategy. How do they make these matchups? Is this the right guy to fight against this guy? And I think the Parisian coach did a good job by saving his best, Kevin Rabaud. In the semis, he brought his best team at home.
Sure.
And as opposed to the LA Matadors, who put their best team on the road in Astana and lost 4-1.
At home, yeah.
Those road trips made the difference. That's another element to the World Series of Boxing, road trips.
Yeah, and you know, we talked about it earlier in the season, Alan, about how important and even more important the coaches were going to be. You know, the coaches pick which team play and what they want on the card.
Here we go. Now he's getting the better of that exchange. Mussafirov knows it and tries to come back on his own. I'm telling you what, somebody might go down in this one.
This is awesome.
Going to the body.
It's Chadi. Mussafirov going to the head.
23 seconds. They're both a little gas. There's that left hook over the top. Mussafirov does not have the pop that Chadi does, but Chadi's looking.
punches that they throw. And I exaggerate, but it seems like it.
Seems like more to them.
Well, Mussafirov tried to come on to the end of this round.
Big ending
for Mussafirov. Roar staggering back to his corner now, Chadi.
Yeah,
he may be hurt.
Yeah, something caught him in there. They gotta take a look at him.
He got cracked.
He got cracked somewhere around here.
Yeah,
maybe
it is. There's a good left hook from Chadi. Chadi had a pretty good round up until the last 45 seconds of it. And he got cracked with something. He seemed to wilt, and he's wobbly as he walked back to his corner. There's a good left hook. That may have been it right there. Chadi come back with his hook. And Mussafirov. Amazing. Look at this.
I didn't see the punch, but I know he got popped with something. Now I can see the coaches over there.
He got taxed. And when that happens, as a coach, you need to remind your fighter, look, you got to get refreshed here. Take a deep breath. Maybe put an ice pack on the back of the neck or on the top of the head. You refresh them. Give them some water. There he goes. Pouring some water on his head. Mussafirov, boy, he is just stealthy. Just like a wolf, like an Arlan.
Round three, lightweight division.